He probably feels that the defender's impeded him, so he can't get at the keeper there. But once again, new international, he's got to learn to sort of button his lip and just bite on the bullet, if you like, and then wait his time.
Working area of Poland this, and they're getting a bit of cheer at the moment, but their side leading by a goal to nil and inside the last 15 minutes of this World Cup qualifier. A goal kick for Poland. He'll probably make another substitution shortly, won't he, Ron? I mean, his hand, Lee Sharp, warming up fairly rapidly. Tommy Adams there complaining that he was harshly done by there by Furcock, and a free kick to England.
I know it would be a very difficult decision, because sometimes you look at your quality, your genius, your flair players, but it looks as if one of those would have to come on.
Nigel Clough.
I mean, I would have thought Lee Sharp was stitched on. I know we said it earlier, I thought he should have been on earlier, but I would have thought he was stitched on to come on at this stage. I really can't see where Nigel Clough is going to play unless he plays in a straight swap for Teddy Sheringham, and I can't subscribe to that at all. Sheringham's looked our best chance of a goal.
Clough for Gascoigne, possibly?
Yes, I think I was about to make that point earlier, but I think Paul Gascoigne, who, you know, is undoubtedly a marvellous player, but isn't playing well at the moment. And to me, actually doesn't look fit. I thought actually he'd have taken him off into the palm.
Oh, it's not here again. It's Bardsley. Well, it comes all the way through for Wright. They haven't picked him up. Wright's done well. And the whistle had gone. The referee claiming it was a handball by Ian Wright.
Whatever, there's a time for him to open his account for England, it's got to be now, wouldn't it? That's a very good opportunity, Stefan.
And a yellow card to Bacco for time-wasting, presumably, the goalkeeper. So Nigel Clough is coming on. Let's just see who it is going off. Our feeling is it might be Paul Gascoigne, in fact. But they can't get Nigel on at the moment. Adams with a header. Back by Ince to Chris Woods. Bardsley. Ooh, a complete miss kick there in the defence. Svierczewski gets it away. That can't hold up his own check. Minsky. And a goal kick. No, it looked a goal kick to me, but the referee's given a corner. And now the substitution will be made. Paul Gascoigne will come off. Still trying to attract the Swiss referee's attention to get Nigel Clough on. Frustrating that for England. They want to get their man on and just can't catch the referee's eye. And Vixen has also gone forward now for Poland. There's Gascoigne coming off, mask and all. And Nigel Clough will take his place. Creating something we hope just behind the strikers, but at the moment doing a job in defence. It comes through the Furtok, and unsurprising them allow that to go as far as that. Barnes jockeying over there. Sorry, Ron.
Also surprised he made a substitution when we're defending a corner.
With a clearance. Too high for Sheringham. Right on the far side now. Adams has gone forward to support his Arsenal teammate. Now Bardsley will keep it going for England. Time running out and the goal is so important. Barnes couldn't get in there. Sheringham plays it in again. Then the player's gone down. I think it was Ian Wright who went down. The referee said no penalty, but it's a corner for England. Bacco in trouble. Clough will take this corner. Just hope this referee is going to add time on for all this time wasting. Loaded in there towards Bacco. Adams couldn't get to it. Dorigo touching it in again, but the whistle's gone for a foul on the goalkeeper. Gascoigne incidentally went off. Also had a cut, I'm just going to say, had a cut leg. Lee Sharp on the left. Team Doctor on the right, and really quite a nasty injury that Gascoigne's got there. Not a severe cut. Very much withdrawn now, David Platt. Walker heading it back for Woods. Time running out. We are well inside the last 10 minutes now. A foul on Sheringham. Takes a bit of a buffeting there from number five, Lesiak. Waiting for Nigel Clough to come across and take this free kick. Max in there, Wright's in there. Adams is in there. A few elbows flying in there, a bit of pushing and shoving going on there. Delivered a good one in there, did Nigel Clough. Couldn't quite reach Adams with it though. Ince now trying to twinkle toes his way through, but the ball comes out to Furtok. He's got Sviatchevsky up alongside him, but some good defending here by Tony Dorigo. At least he's got back there to hold things up for a moment. Certainly are excellent on the counter-attack for Poland, and their pace so often tonight has caught England out. Ince getting it forward. Sheringham can't get on the end of it.
They've given us a lesson tonight, in actual fact, in movement and pace, haven't they? I mean, their support play has been absolutely superb. They sprinted to support people. They've sprinted back to help colleagues out. And England have been, for me, very, very, very predictable.
Walker hits it forward. Barnes takes it on the chest. At the moment, England taking it on the chin. Sochuk gets it away. Clough with a header. Poles got above them all, but there was a foul. There must have been some pushing down and a free kick to England, but a way out. And Gascoigne's gone. There's no free kick possible for him, so Ince plays it wide for David Bardsley. The cross comes in from him. Kosminski gets it away. In again for England, this time Barnes. Now Dorigo, a little flick, gets it wide of his man. Barnes, another little flick, gets it up to Dorigo, crashes up ahead of him. Dorigo's cross, and right! And it's in there! And England are level!
Well, some superb quality up the left-hand side, some great joining up play from Tony Dorigo and John Barnes, and then that lovely slotty cross in. And as we said earlier, what a great time for Ian Wright to open his account. But all stems from some good play up the left-hand side between Barnes and Dorigo, and that lovely flighted ball. I think the Poles were actually trying to catch him offside. I think they thought Wright was coming up, was going to be offside, but he certainly wasn't.
Well, the man who's been eight caps before tonight has not scored, and it's become a bit of a phobia with him. Look at that, he's celebrating now. And a great ball played in there, and a super finish by Ian Wright. His first goal for England, and he's chosen the best possible moment to get it.
Certainly think they'll make strong claims that Wright was offside, you know. But for me, he came in on the blind side of the sweeper. He took his chance very well.
Free kick to Poland. Let's see what England can do here. He can defend with determination and discipline and hope that in the time that's left, it's about 5 minutes, they can yet produce something else at the other end. But first, there's defending to be done. Up goes Tony Adams, but doesn't get to it. It's Clough who gets it away. Lesiak. That comes away. Poland, when that goal was who scored actually brought on Jaloka, another substitute. And here's Wright again, taking that little plodding pass from Nigel Clough. Hardly forward. Well, there's a bit of relief for Graham Taylor now. What a moment for Ian Wright, though. For so long he'd gone in an England shirt and hadn't scored, Ron.
Yes, and I suppose there were a few startled eyebrows when he wasn't in the lineup at the beginning, but funny how things work out for you.
I think Graham Taylor probably felt that he wasn't totally fit. He's had these problems with his foot injury after the cup final, and he said, I think maybe he's in the best place here on the substitutes bench, but he actually said, what a wonderful insurance if we need him late in the game. And that's exactly the way it's turned out to be. Dorigo battling away. He's had a good game, Tony Dorigo, holding up for Gorzetsky. Again, Ince, Shevchek, back heel. Kosminski, Adams with a header. So many times in Graham Taylor's reign, England have thrown away good positions and possible winning positions, but they've fought really well now in this second half. And still their form hasn't been all that good, but that bit of work there by Tony Adams really exemplifies the way England have played in this second half with a lot of spirit. Though Ron was saying predictable, quite right, but their spirit has never flagged.
And it'll certainly get better now, won't it, with the goal, the encouragement of the goal.
Adams again. Now, can England get a second one? Up goes Ian Wright. Dorigo coming for this one. Loses out that time. Poland can take it up again. Swierczewski. Must not concede anything here now, but Bardsley should be in control here, knocking it forward. Wright coming deep to pick it up. Free kick to England. David Platt. Sheringham couldn't quite flick it wide for Barnes. Adams. Oh, hits it straight though to the number 8, Adamczuk. Kozetski. Coming to the last couple of minutes now, and a free kick to Poland, conceded by Tony Dorigo. Ball needs to be set up securely. Woods needs to be alert. England must give nothing away here. The big defender, Shevchek, coming forward once again. He hits a very fierce free kick. 2-4-5 in the wall, plus a pole. And well, no danger to that one. Overall view of the England performance here tonight. If they do snatch a point, it's going to be so vital, Ron.
Yeah, if it stays like this, a far, far better result than the performance. I haven't been over impressed with the cohesion of the performance, if you like. We've worked hard. No score, no doubts about that score, but we haven't really looked inventive, have we? We've looked predictable, and our best, you know, from one of the few moments of quality play, we've scored. I mean, the link up on the left-hand side between Barnes and Dorigo before the goal was super, and it was a lovely ball into the box.
It's a Polish throw here. The last few seconds now. get it back to goalkeeper Bacco. He'll just bang it forward now and hope that the front men can do something for Poland. No. Taking it steady. Szachowski. Lesiak. Dorigo content to get it back to Chris Woods.
I bet Lesniak is taking a little bit of stick on the bench now, don't you, for those misses?
Yes, two glaring chances that the Poles had, both falling to one of their best strikers. It's Lesniak who's on the bench. Lesiak is still on the field, the defender. Throw to Poland, playing time added on at the end of 90 minutes now. I think Graham Taylor was looking for 3 points from these two games, here and against Norway. It's still so important that England win in Norway on Wednesday night, providing they can hold on to this 1-1 draw here that they've battled for in Katowice. Max up to Sheringham. But the Poles are so quick getting back, having lost the ball. They got back so quickly that time. It was Kosminski. Got back to Chris Woods. There goes the final whistle. It's a 1-1 draw with Adamczuk having scored for Poland just before half time, and Ian Wright scoring that vital goal with just 7 minutes left. 1-1 the final score here in Katowice.
Striking oil, striking a rich, the American dream. What about the men behind that dream? The men who drink Coors.
Gusher! We got a Gusher!
A Gusher!
Gusher? There's no Gusher in my script.
All right, cut. Don't worry, John.
A Gusher! Let's go take a closer look while I enjoy this Coors. Cold, filthy. What's this?
A geisha.
A Gusher! The script said a Gusher!
Well, I've got geisha.
Oh, it's a Gusher!
I've got geisha.
Hi! I'm here talking to this fellow about Coors. Cold filter,
John. We gotta go in there.
Oh, we gotta go in there.
We're out of here.
Oh, this isn't my contract.
We're going in, Cubs. It's getting awfully dark in here.
See you for the bar scene, John.
Here's to the end of another hard day.
Hey, Mons, Coors.
How about Coors?
Somebody pass him one of those Coors. Coors over here.
Hey, buddy, have you seen John?
I am John.
Ow.
Coors Extra Gold. Cold filtered for a...
For the thick-cut chip with the big potato taste, there's nothing like the real McCoy.
I invited the neighbors over. Think they'll come?
They'll come.
The real McCoy. The big chip from the big country.
Eeny, 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 eeny. Eenie. Today, Mr. Bingley is looking at the choice of pension companies offered to him by a typical top 10 building society.
Eenie.
Bradford and Bingley, a wider choice of pensions than
Eenie.
Other top 10 society.
Right now at Quick Fit, you can buy tires and exhaust at really low prices and not have to pay a penny until later. Can you afford to go anywhere else?
Right Guard with double protection. It works hardest when you need it most.
Dulux Pure Brilliant White is so thick, it covers a multitude of sins.
This man has AXA Equity and Law Life Assurance. If anything happens to him, his wife will be a rich woman. I wonder who that was. AXA Equity and Law. Need we say more?
ITV Tonight at the later time of 9:30.
Now, if this boy was ever in here, I want to know, because he's dead now.
The Bill, tonight, 9:30.
Welcome back. Well, England getting a battling draw over there in Poland, and Jim Rosenthal has England manager Graham Taylor with him.
Graham, you told us at half-time football was all about using their heads. What do you mean by that?
Using their brains. We ran around like headless chickens in the first half. I mean, you can't question this side's commitment at all, and it was there in the first half. But you can't just run all over the pitch and lose the shape of your team. And we were fighting a war in the first half and not playing a game of football. Now, we know these places are difficult to come to, but you cannot get yourself involved. You can't concentrate on the game if you're interested in retaliation. And once you start to use your head, at least we got a little bit, because it is an intense atmosphere.
Inspired substitution or just a little stroke of luck there, Graham?
Well, I mean, I think I have to say now again, I fancied him 20 minutes. I did say that's the place to come off the bench. And I did tell him, I said, look, we'll give you 20 minutes to score your goal. So I'm pleased he did it.
Where do you feel...
Well, let's look at that goal. That was a key goal for Ian Wright. His first goal for England, and one, obviously, that he was desperate for.
It was a great little build-up, wasn't it? It was the first time, really, we put some passes together with Barnsley and Dorigo. And Dorigo's put in a smashing cross. Where the left-back was, I never know, but that's a difficult technique and skill. I mean, it was on the half-volley. It wasn't a volley. It's a great finish, really. And pleased for the lad to get off the mark like that in a vital game.
As you see, it was a lovely little bit of skill down the left-hand side, and a great ball by Dorigo.
I think they were looking for offside, weren't they? But looking at the replay, I think he's just sneaked round the back and timed it to perfection, and he's kept his head well. A bit of luck with the goalkeeper, he didn't come off him and come out, but the technique was fantastic.
Right, well, it's football on ITV Network. We'll be coming up shortly, but first of all, we'll just take a quick look at Group 2. And there you are, England. And not a bad position, Glenn.
Yeah, we're still in that second spot, but obviously Norway is the most important game now. If we can get a win there, it'll set us up nicely. But I think we were a little bit let off the hook tonight.
Do you think so?
Oh, I think so. With the misses that the Polish lad, was it Lesniak? I think really, we were let off the hook.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Glenn, for joining me tonight, and good luck Monday at Wembley. From us here, bye-bye.
Next, The Bill.
When it comes to the acid test, Andrew's Antacid tablets help relieve heartburn, acid indigestion, and trapped wind.
Suck 'em and see.
Wrigley's Spearmint Gum. Great to chew. Even better to share.
Let's move before they raise the parking rate. Ow! All right.
cool, refreshing Wrigley's Spearmint Gum.
Sunday night comedy at 6:30, watching, and at 7, does she mean me?
It's you, Sue.
And surprise, surprise, Cliff is Scylla's star guest. All the more surprising, Claude in a Cadillac, heartbeat at 8.
What ho, what ho, what ho?
Take that at 9, Jeeves and Wooster. And take this at 10, Lauren Bacall, John Sessions and Phil Collins. Aspel live on Sunday.
Now, later than usual, due to tonight's football coverage, The Bill. London's Burning will be back at its usual time of 8:30 next Saturday.
For the parents.
Suspect drowning, young kid, right?
Yeah, that's the one.
Got him.
I don't believe you met Polly Page. Stan.
No, I had the pleasure. Stan Grant.
Hi.
You doing the identification?
That's right.
Very considerate of your governor to find you one that's only been in a day or so.
Who's the pathologist on this one?
Mr. Myers. You should get something tomorrow. Looks like a routine drowning. Not a lot for forensics, but he's in good nick. Shouldn't be out of place. Oh, there is this. Nice little butterfly tattoo. Dinky. I'll tell you something else. It's been a long time since he had a decent wash. He's got nits.
Age between 14 and 16 years. Male, IC1.
Sierra, height 5 foot.